My father, Tom Chattaway, made this movie for a contest at the Luanshya Camera Club. I think he won second prize. He intended it to be a combination of a documentary and a comedy. I think I'm operating the puppet there. And this hedge in the background is actually at 6 Jacaranda Avenue. So every morning, this sunrise here, although it looks like a sunrise, actually my dad shot a sunset, cut it in 3 pieces, put the beginning and end here in reverse order as the sunrise, and the middle piece is at the end of the movie as the sunset. So our day is usually started about 6 a.m. And if you looked out in the front yard, bird would be out there feeding on our typical African lawn, different type of grass than we have in Canada. I don't know what kind of bird it is. I've been asked. I don't know. But we had lots of them, and they'd sit on the power line. And then at 6 o'clock in the morning, down at the power station where my dad worked, they'd blow the steam whistle to wake people up and let them know shift change is coming. And when that sound was heard all over town, all the birds would fly away from the power line. Happened every morning. So it's time for Dad to go to work, and here he is in his old Morris Cowley vanette and about to start it up. So he's given our gardener the crank handle. Now this of course is a joke because it really didn't work properly, but my dad's joke, I've got to get either a new battery or a stronger boy. And you can tell that he's not really pushing. Here we are going around G Avenue at the top of the hill on the side where we lived at 6 J Avenue. And that little puppet that's hanging into the window there, is his name is Sam Hanwich, and he's a sailor puppet from the SS Uganda, which we were on 2 years before this. This is the 4th Street Bridge in those days, and we've suddenly taken a leap over to the surface works of the mine area, and my dad's heading towards his work in the power plant. Meantime, it's time for me to go to school. So there we are with our Morris Oxford and 55 model, and I have forgotten something, but here comes our house servant. He's going to remind me that I've left my school satchel at home. So we're off to school. We're going to take the other road from this side of the river to the other side. So not 4th Street, but the other one by the golf course. You see us turn the corner. Notice the continuation of that street is dirt there, still at that stage. I have no idea what my mom was saying here, but my dad thought it was worth including in the movie. And now we're approaching the corner of E Avenue and the Indola Road. Lovely gardens throughout Luanshya. And here's my dad at work at the power station. And the first job he's going to do is supervise the loading of wood from the wood yard. So at that time there was still burning wood. Later it was coal. And the wood was stored in the wood yard. Trucks would come in bringing it from the bush, wherever it was cut. And people would unload it manually, one stick at a time, onto these piles in the wood yard. And then once it was all unloaded, now each stick had to be reloaded again to get it into the boilers. So these rail cars were let down on a long wire and a winch, and when they got to the bottom, they unhooked the wire and then they pushed them around the corner. Into the middle of the wood yard, and then they'd get near the piles of wood and start loading it on. My dad noticed after a while when we reviewed this movie that the person loading the first car is looking for the smallest ones, easiest to pick up. And the person loading the second one is looking for the larger ones because they get the job done quicker that way. Each person has their own way of being efficient, I guess. So it was hauled up to the next, actually two stories high, up to where the boilers were loaded with fuel. Once it got to the top, the winch was disconnected again. It was pushed by hand around the corner, one car at a time, and over to where the furnaces for the boilers were, and it was tossed into the fire to boil steam to drive the turbines. So now you're in the turbine room, so these men are busy turning large valves, and my dad would come around once every half hour or hour and check the gauges and write down the most important readings so there was a record. I always thought of him when I later on designed control rooms. Later on, when he was promoted to shift engineer, he worked in the main control room. There he is, starting his rounds. It was the noisiest place I've ever been in, and yet I don't remember anybody wearing ear protection there. Those turbines used to scream. And here we are on the Indola Road, going the opposite way back towards E Avenue. And out of school, so here I'm carrying a paper plane, getting in the car, and we're on our way home. We're back now on G Avenue, on our side of the river, and heading towards home. At 3 o'clock, the next hooter goes at work. That's shift change time, so we go home. And it's tea time. We had a table made from an old cable drum, and tea was brought to the garden, and so we've all got our tea. Would you like a piece of cake? Yes. Would you like a piece of cake? Yes, please. Okay, one for you, one for you, and all the rest for me. And there he goes, munching right on the cake. My mother couldn't keep a straight face here. We're supposed to look... It was supposed to be something we did every day, but she couldn't hold it. I'm asking my dad if it's time to go fishing, and if there's time, and he looks at his watch and checks, yeah, there is time to go fishing. So I load the rod onto the back of the Venette, and I get in on the back. No seat belts. There's Timmy, our dog. He was trying to get in, but I didn't see him coming. So he couldn't get in that door. And then he just a bit too late to get in my dad's door, too. He missed him there. Then he went over to see my mom, and she actually waited for Timmy to get in the car. So now we're heading off towards Macoma Dam, which was the tailings dam and recreational lake for our town, and later on became one of the main water supplies. Now, what are we seeing here? I have to tell you, we never saw this much around Luanshya. Certainly not lions, and we very seldom saw one of these antelopes. But My dad had arranged the scenes. He actually got these scenes when we were visiting the Wanky Game Reserve, and he spliced them into his home movie to make it a little bit more spicy. So here's a bunch of lions we met. If you look carefully, I think there's about 6 lions in the scene, but you have to look hard for them. It's easy to see them when they move. Of course, my dad bravely challenges these lions. And they react, and he says, uh-oh, better be careful here. Gonna get back in and close all the doors. And we watch the lions go by. So we continue our journey on to Makoma Club. There's a nice jetty for launching boats, and there's picnic areas, shallow bay where kids like to play, and the main yachting and power boating section is the big lake behind. This is only about 5 miles from town. That's my mom chatting with her friend Nancy Brown and her 3 daughters. That would be Diane, Heather, and I've forgotten the 3rd one. I kind of remember this day, even remember part of the conversation they were having. I was 12. This would be 1957 or early 58. That's myself in the green trunks and Gary Harrison in the red ones. He was in my class at school. He was the headmaster's son and very slim. He'd had polio as a child. We're still in touch. So we're getting into the old boat that's moored there and using it as a diving platform into this fairly shallow bay. Which is a lot of fun. We were also Sea Scouts, and we'd come out here on the weekends, and they would have us rescue people whose yacht had flipped on its side. Learned to swim from my mom, which is unusual in Luanshya. Most people learn from Waddy Watson, who was the supervisor of the swimming pool. And here is, I think it's Dave Smith's boat, and it's sinking. There was a big drop-off at the bottom of that water there, and I just fell in it. And now we're on our way home. And there's our African sunset, African trees. And that was life in Luanshya.